Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. If x, y, and z are real numbers, x, y, and z are bigger than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to 1, we need to prove this inequality. This is a very challenging question. We're going to use the calculus method to derive the proof. We define the left-hand side of this inequality as the function of f of x, y, z. We rewrite the right-hand side as the following. It's easy to take the first order derivative on the right-hand side. The first order derivative of f with respect to x equals this. Here, I mean the partial derivative. We consider the second order derivative of f. Rewrite the right-hand side as the following. Because x, y, and z are bigger than or equal to 0, then we have this part, which is bigger than or equal to 0. This means the second order derivative of f with respect to x is bigger than or equal to 0. From this given question, all x, y, and z are symmetric. By symmetry, we have similar results. The partial derivative of f with respect to y, I mean the second order, is bigger than or equal to 0. The second order derivative of f with respect to z is bigger than or equal to 0. Here is the conclusion. F of x, y, z is concave up in all x, y, z directions. Sometimes we call this is a convex function. From the given domain, x, y, z are between 0 and 1. From the optimization result, the maximum of f can only occur at n points. This means x, y, z only take values of 0 and 1. By symmetry, we only need to check f values at these points. All values are 0. Only one value is 1, the other two are 0. Two values are 0, only one value is 0. Two values are 1. All values are 1. For example, here, 1, 0, 0, we have different combination. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. If we plug in here, you will have the same result. By checking, if we replace x, y, z by 0, 0, 0, then the left-hand side is 0. If you replace x, y, z by 1, 1, 1, you have 1/3 plus 1/3 plus 1/3, which is 1. If we replace x, y, z by 1, 0, 0, you will have one half, excuse me. One over 0, 0 plus one is one. Here is zero, that's one equals one. Therefore, the maximum value by checking these 4 points, which is one. For example, f at 1, 1, 1. Therefore, we have done the proof. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.